termed as alternating current, AC. Alternating current. Chapter name is AC. It is also a very important chapter, especially the numericals given in NCERT are very important in this chapter to do. Before that, first you understand what is alternating EMF. What is an alternating EMF? An EMF whose magnitude changes continuously with time and the direction is termed as alternating EMF. I repeat, an EMF whose magnitude changes continuously with time and direction reverses periodically is called alternating EMF. Or you can say it is an EMF whose magnitude as well as direction changes with respect to time periodically. So this EMF is written as E is equal to E naught sin omega t. This equation is similar to Y is equal to A sin omega t, SHM equation which you have done in class 11th. What was Y? Instantaneous displacement or displacement of a particle at any time. A, we call it as amplitude or maximum displacement covered. Right. Similarly, it is here. E is termed as instantaneous EMF. Instantaneous EMF or EMF at any time. E naught is also similarly termed as EMF amplitude or maximum EMF or peak value of EMF. Rest is omega. Omega has its own significance, 2 pi nu, where nu is the frequency. When you plot a graph, because equation is identical to simple harmonic equation, so graph will be exactly same. Here you can see the maximum EMF plus, this is minus E naught, and this is variation of instantaneous EMF. Similarly, you can write also for equation for current, I is equal to I naught sin omega t. When your EMF source is giving you alternating EMF, then obviously the current which will flow through a conductor will be alternating current. And if you look at this expression, this current is time varying, so its magnitude is changing all the times. That's what we were talking in mutual induction so many times, that use a coil number one and connect it to an alternating EMF source. So current automatically changes with respect to the time in the coil. So there is no need to maintain a relative motion between two coils in order to introduce mutual induction. Now this is also has same meaning, instantaneous current, current at any instant. This is called current amplitude or maximum current or peak value of current, whatever you like you can call it. If you plot a graph between I and omega t, again this will be similar to the graph. All graphs are identical. Why? Because these are changing, values are changing according to the sinusoidal function. So what we are going to talk in this chapter, we are basically discussing about so many things. Behavior of resistance offering elements with AC in AC circuits, as well as the combination of elements in AC circuit. So we discuss about all these things and few more things which we are going to do here. That is, number one is mean or average value of alternating current. So with a small introduction, what is this? Let's move with the article. First article is mean or average value of AC. What is definition of mean value or average value of alternating current? You can write it down if you want, otherwise no problem. The mean or average value of alternating current over any half cycle. Any half cycle of AC means time interval is T by 2, because time period is normally assumed as capital T or T. So I repeat it again, let's come back to the definition. The mean or average value of AC over any half cycle is defined as that value of steady current means direct current, which would send the same amount of charge through a conductor in a time of half cycle as is sent by AC. Quickly repeat, the mean or average value of alternating current of any or over any half cycle is defined as the value of steady current which would send the same amount of charge in the conductor or in the time of half cycle as is sent by AC in the same time. What actually we are doing practically here, we are comparing the amount of charge. This is a conductor, right? I passed some magnitude of alternating current through it for some time. There will be some amount of charge passes and flows through the conductor. Let it be Q. Let the amount of charge flowing is Q. Now what I am trying to find, I am trying to calculate instead of AC, अगर मैं DC use करूँ तो, steady current use करूँ तो, same amount of charge flow करने के लिए, same time के अंदर, किस magnitude की DC चाहिए? समझ आया? Comparison है, I magnitude की AC pass की Q time के लिए, Q charge flow करता है किसी time के लिए, मान लो T. अब मैं जानना चाह रहा हूं कि what magnitude of DC I should pass through it so that same amount of charge passes through a conductor in the same time. ठीक है? देखो, तो कर लेते हैं, assume कर लेते हैं पहले तो. If IM steady current is passed, for time T by 2, for any half cycle, then amount of charge flowing Q is equal to IM into T by 2. Now I magnitude of AC is passed. Passed for time dt. अब मैंने यहाँ dt क्यों लिया, बिकॉज I इज ऑल्टरनेटिंग करंट एंड इट्स वेरिंग, मैग्नीट्यूड इज वेरिंग फॉर एवरी स्मॉल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ टाइम. सो द चार्ज पास्ट, चार्ज फ्लोज will be dq is equal to I dt. Therefore, total charge q is equal to integration of dq, that is integration of I dt, limit is 0 to t by 2, right? Now, I magnitude is what? I naught sin omega t. Integration 0 to t by 2 dt. I naught you can bring out. Integration 0 to t by 2 sin omega t. That you can do easily. That comes out I naught minus cos omega t over omega 0 to t by 2. Solve this integration, already we have solved it. So now you have just to substitute the lower and upper limit in the integration and you will get the amount of charge passed through the conductor due to alternating current. So when we put the value, the q comes out here 2 I naught over omega minus cos omega, you can put 2 pi over t, upper limit t by 2, minus minus plus cos 0, t cancels, 2 cancels, cos pi is minus 1, so it comes out 2 I naught over omega. This will be the amount of charge flowing through the circuit when AC is passed, right? Now this charge and that charge in equation must equating with equation number 1, equation 1. So I m into t by 2 is equal to 2 I naught over omega, that is I m t by 2 2 I naught omega is 2 pi into t. T gets cancelled, 2 gets cancelled. So I am positive is equal to 2 I naught over pi. Why did I said I am positive? Because you see the limit. I have taken limit of the integration from 0 to t by 2. And limit 0 to 2 by 2 technically corresponds to positive half cycle. For negative half cycle, limit will be t by 2 to t, right? Now for positive half cycle is this, then similarly for negative half cycle, you can write I am negative minus 2 I naught over pi. Therefore, average charge flowing through a conductor in complete cycle you can say it is I m plus, or I can put it here I m plus plus I m minus into time capital T. This is zero. This is brilliant conclusion that in AC circuit in one complete cycle there is no net flow of charge. When for positive half cycle current, say if it moves like this, then for negative half cycle it comes back. So there is no net flow charge for the one complete cycle in AC circuits. That's a brilliant answer. But similarly, you can write for mean value of AC EMF also in the same manner. Mean value or average value of EMF, same manner you can say EM positive 2E naught over pi, that is 0.637 E naught. E minus EM minus is minus 2E naught pi, that is again 0.637 E naught. So result is identical. This value is also 0.637 I0. Article RMS value or virtual value of AC. In previous article, mean value or average value of alternating current, what did I compare? I compare about the same amount of charge flowing through a conductor. When you are passing DC through a conductor, when you pass AC through a conductor. Somewhat same thing we are going to do here, but we are not comparing charge this time obviously. We are going to compare the amount of heat energy produced. So, how do we write definition of RMS value of alternating current or virtual value of alternating current? If you want, you can write it down. I am dictating. It is defined as, or RMS value of current AC, RMS value of AC is defined as that value of steady current. Steady current again stands for direct current, which would generate same amount of heat energy through a given resistor in a given time as is done by AC when passed through the same resistor for the same time. I repeat, RMS value of AC is defined as that value of steady current which would generate the same amount of heat energy in a given resistor in a given time as is done by AC when passed through same resistor for the same time. So let's consider and continue. There is a resistance R. Consider resistance R. And IV, V stands for virtual. If IV steady current is passed, for time t, then heat energy generated is I square V R T. This is the heat energy which is generated by DC. Now, I magnitude of AC is passed. For time dt, then heat energy produced dH is equal to I square R dt. Therefore, total heat H is equal to integration dH integration I square R dt limit 0 to t. Now, I's value we know in AC. What is the value of I? You know it now. So, put the value integration 0 to t I naught square sine square omega t R dt. I naught square you can take common, R you can take common, 0 to t sin square omega t dt. So you have to solve this integration. Once this integration is solved, you have done with it, and it cannot be directly integrated, so you write use formula sin square omega t 1 minus cos 2 omega t over 2. Put this value of sin square omega t. So now I am working with integration only. Then 0 to t 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2 dt. You can divide into two integrations, 0 to t dt, 1 by 2, here also cos 2 omega t dt, 0 to t. This is always 0 because sine cosine function integrate over whole cycle is 0, and this will comes out to be t by 2. So equation 3 becomes what? Heat energy produced is I naught square R T by 2. I can put this equation number 4. Equating with equation number 1. That is IB square RT, I naught square RT by 2, TT cancels, R cancel, IB is equal to I naught by root 2. Similarly, you can write virtual value of EMF E naught by root 2. This value is 0.707 I naught. So this value also you can write root 2 is also equal to 0.707 E naught. That's how you can get this value.